franktalks.com.
Recently, there was another mass shooting in the U.S., this time in Santa Barbara, California, where a young man who apparently did have mental issues decided to go on a rampage because he said women did not want to have a relationship with him and he was still a virgin at the age of 22. Now, there are many facts that still need to be figured out before this incident can be put to rest, but one area that has a lot of people talking is this admission of the young man being upset at women for not having sexual relations with him. To discuss this aspect is relationship coach Frank Kermit. Frank, welcome back to The Kelly Alexander Show.
Thank you very much, Kelly.
Frank, first of all, did this man's reasoning surprise you when we started getting details of this incident?
Did it surprise me in the sense of his rage, of his anger, of his hurt? No, it didn't. One of the branches of my practice is that I actually work with adult male virgins. I've written a book for them. I've held seminars for them. And the hurt and anger and frustration that he described is actually very common. Guys who are basically nice guys, who are perhaps socially awkward, simply can't get a girlfriend, and they're trying to figure out why. The fact is, the majority of these guys, the vast majority, the 99% of them, are basically nice guys, can't get a date, and all they really want is a girlfriend.
Okay. Now, I don't want to spend too much time on the shooter, but I did want to ask this. You know, obviously, from what we understand, you know, more details are coming out that it does sound that he very much did have other mental issues going on, which maybe is part of the reason why he couldn't process the situation, you know, in a more calm manner. But are you, you know, sort of surprised, I guess, again, is the wrong word, but to use it, that this aggression that he had was at the forefront of his apparent rampage?
Well, here's the thing. I have worked with men like this, and they do talk about this type of frustration. Is that a motivation to go out and commit violence? No. Most of the men that I have counseled wouldn't commit violence to a group of people or go on any sort of violent shooting spree, stabbing spree, whatever you want to call it. Most of these guys, if they were going to do harm to anybody, they'd be doing harm to themselves. What I think happened in his case, and again, I wasn't his counselor, so I can't say for any certainty, but from what I've seen in my practice, all women in his case became a symbol for everything that was wrong in his life. And what most people need to understand is that when someone is that mentally ill, even if that person did in fact get himself a girlfriend or two, it wouldn't have changed the outcome. Because the outcome for him is, this particular group of people is a symbol for everything that's wrong with my life. And if he did get himself a girlfriend, and oh, lo and behold, one day they're going to get into a fight, maybe they're going to break up, rather than move on to date somebody new, no, it's got to be bad, this is wrong, there's the expectation that it was supposed to be perfect and solve all of my problems. And when it doesn't, the same type of reaction comes back. This has nothing to do with his virginity. Okay. His virginity may have been where he identified his rage and aggression, and I think his virginity was a symbol for everything that was wrong with the world. But that's just not the case for people who are not mentally ill.
Now, moving away from him, but in the same vein, is there, you know, really a lot of anxiety surrounding adult male virgins? You know, are they worried about being stigmatized?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Women are on the receiving end of sexual attention. Her decision as to whether or not she gets sex at any given point is whether or not she says yes or no. Men have to work for it. They have to put themselves out there. They have to take the risk of rejection. They are expected to be the ones to ask somebody out on a date, to be sometimes are expected to pay for the date. Sometimes they're expected to say, well, look, if you get rejected, you have to pick yourself up and move on. And most of the people saying that, hey, just get over it, usually are not the people who are on the receiving end of rejection after rejection after rejection. The older a man gets, where he still has not successfully entered into any sort of relationship, sexual or emotional, the harder it becomes. Because there is a stigma that these men face. Now, if a person is in their early 20s, going up to the mid-20s, well, I'm very shy, I've been too busy with school, I'm just focusing on getting my career underway, there's been no time. once a man hits 25, there's something magical about the number 25 where the pain leading up to 25 is so bad, the anxiety is so overwhelming, that by the time he's 25, that's when he has to admit, there must be something wrong with the way I'm acting because it hasn't worked out for me.
Frank, is there, or is it a lonely path for adult male virgins because of the fact that, you know, this is obviously, even though I'm sure on a certain level, it should not be something, you know, to be embarrassed to speak about. But obviously, I think a lot of guys would be embarrassed and would not want to share this with close friends or even like a, you know, a brother or an uncle or even a dad. So is it a lonely path? And is that where things can spiral out of control if they're not expressing themselves properly?
It's a very lonely path when men finally come to me and they say, I saw your book. I saw you wrote a book, The Adult Male Virgin Handbook. You're the only person I can talk to about this. In many cases, men have bullied their male friends for being virgins. Some men have come out and admitted it to girls, and the girls decided, well, this is way too much pressure. And, you know, if a girl had to choose between dating two guys and one of them admitted he was a virgin, it was held against him. So there is a stigma, and men can't really talk about it. Who can he go to and say, look, I'm a virgin, and I'm really struggling with this? The overall attitude is, just go pay for it.
Right.
Go to a prostitute and pay for it. Adult male virgins don't want to go to prostitutes, and a lot of them are very successful in the working world. They have money. They could afford it. They don't want to go to the prostitutes because they don't want their first time to have sex to be with a prostitute. They really want to lose their virginity to a girl they care about. They want to be in a relationship. They want a girlfriend. At the very least, they want to be with that female friend that they care about who's always rejected them. So it's not just about going out and paying for it and getting sex. These guys want something more intimate, and they're struggling just to achieve that. Sometimes it's because they want it so bad they come across needy. Sometimes it's the fact that they're really nice guys, and on some level, they want to save some girls. So they go after girls who are constantly dating jerks, and they're saying, but if I show her that I can treat her well, she'll like me. And we all know that doesn't work in the real world.
Do a lot of us in society just assume that it's easier for guys to give up their virginity than women? Like, it almost seems like, you know, as many connotations as there are towards women about certain things, I feel like this is one that we would think, oh, come on now.
Yes, absolutely. People think that, well, if you're a guy, you're encouraged to go after it. Here's what people don't factor in. Over the last 50 years, men who act like men, who get sexually aggressive, who make a move, are now being punished for it in certain circles. So a guy asks out a girl, now he has to worry about sexual harassment. When there may have been no sexual harassment per se, it's just a question of she didn't like him enough to say yes. So he's afraid to ask out a girl. He's afraid to hurt a girl. Most of these guys are nice guys who would never harm a woman. So they feel that maybe showing interest might make the girl feel uncomfortable. So they don't even show interest. These guys just are, for lack of a better term, socially challenged, and they are in a system where they feel the rules are rigged against them. Damned if they do, damned if they don't. People just assume, well, it's easy for a guy because it's just assumed you can go after what you want. Well, just because you go after what you want doesn't mean you're going to get it. I have clients who will go out on a daily basis and try to approach girls, and they'll try everything from the simple, hi, my name is so-and-so, I saw you from over there and I wanted to meet you, to using the corniest lines, figuring something's got to work. And they get rejection after rejection after rejection after rejection. Now you would think, well, at some point, somebody's going to say, sure, I'll have a coffee with you. I like you enough. That's not true. It's the theory that at some point something will happen and it's easier for a guy because he can just go for it. The fact is, you can have guys go for it consistently, but if they're behaving in a way that they don't know is a turnoff, if they may not be the most attractive guy, or if even if they come across as a little bit nervous, they're trying to be funny and it's not coming across as funny, they can face massive amounts of rejection before they ever get that first, maybe I'll go out with you.
Joining us on the show is relationship coach Frank Kermit. Learn more about him on his website, franktalks.com. Frank, you know, if we have someone listening right now that is going through this, what do you want them to know? Like, what is the first step? And again, you don't want to obviously build up that this is a huge problem. Like, maybe it just hasn't happened yet. But, like, by what age do you want someone to be maybe taking active steps?
Okay, here's the first rule. If you are okay with you being a virgin and a man, then you don't need help. If you're okay with it, then be okay with it. Understand, some people won't be okay with it. You may be a target for people to make fun of you and so on. You may be a target for bullying. You may have some women reject you because of it. All right? But if you're okay with it, then it's not a problem. For those of you who are feeling the pressure, for those of you who are feeling the stigma for it, understand something. You are in complete control as to whether or not you will lose your virginity at some point. But you have to commit to the kind of behaviors that are going to work in your favor. Some of those behaviors may not seem familiar to you. Some of those behaviors mean that you might have to give up something fun that you enjoy doing. But if you balance out the pain that you're feeling from being alone with giving up some of your current behaviors and adopting some new behaviors, it's worthwhile in the end.
And if you know that you have, like, let's say you're a family member. Again, this is such a tough subject. Obviously, you know, if you have a member that you know of your family that's struggling with something like this, is there anything a family member can do, or is this really like a battle to be waged on their own? Because again, it's we use the word for like stigma.
Well, you see, just the fact that you asked the question shows just how isolated men are in this field. So a guy is struggling with it, and even a family member is saying, I don't know if I should bring it up to you or not. Anytime you see somebody struggling with something, anytime you see a loved one struggling with something, of course you go speak to them about it and say, hey, look, I see that you're struggling with this. Is there anything that I can do? And maybe the best thing you can do for that person is set them up on a blind date. Introduce them to people that they might like and who might like them. Maybe even talk to the person and say, listen, is there somebody you like that I could help you learn to present yourself better to that person? Of course you should reach out. And that's part of the problem. People don't want to reach out because they feel, oh, maybe the person would feel uncomfortable. The person's already feeling bad. If you're noticing it, obviously it's a problem. Obviously they're in pain, but they wouldn't even know how to ask for help because as men, we are taught part of being a man is to take care of things yourself, and if you ask for help, then there's something wrong with you. Well, that's a wonderful stigma. The reality is sometimes you need something outside of yourself to help you through a situation.
Okay.
And that's men and women.
And Frank, again, if someone is struggling with a situation like this, what type of professional help should they be getting if they so choose to head down that road?
Well, they could seek out a coach like myself who specializes in helping adult male virgins learn about the emotional needs of women and how to behave socially. If the reason that they're holding off from sex and relationships is something deep-rooted, I have some clients who experience things like growing up in a household where the mother figure latches on to the young male and speaks badly about the father and says, your father is bad because of this, and all men are bad because of that. And these young men grow up in a household and become self-hating males. So they just stay out of relationships because they hate themselves so much. And why would they want to do that to a woman? Because they're raised by mothers who hate their fathers and take it out on the children. For stuff like that, go see a psychologist. Go see a psychotherapist.
Okay.
Some children that I know, and when I say children, I mean they're adults when they come to me, but when they were children, I've dealt with men who were told by their parents, by their siblings, you're too ugly. You'll never find a girlfriend. You're not worth it. You better become rich because no woman's going to want you otherwise.
Wow.
So these little boys are growing up receiving so much aggression and hatred as children that they become adults who can't function in relationships. So they're thinking, well, even though that girl over there, she looked at me, she waved, this other girl asked me out on a date, well, there's no point because I know deep inside it's not going to work out anyway. I'm not rich enough. I'm not good looking enough. I'm not strong enough. part of the reason that I went through my own personal development phase and ended up becoming a coach in this area. I was told the same thing by certain people. I was told growing up, you're never going to get married because of this and that. You're never going to get yourself a girlfriend if you continue being the way you are. And those stigmas, when you take those beliefs and you internalize them, that's what stops you from finding love. In the world, there's always going to be people who love you for no reason. There's going to be people who hate you for no reason. But the majority of the people will follow your lead in terms of how to treat you. If you like yourself and treat yourself well, the majority of the people will follow that. But if you hate yourself and you come across as hating yourself, then the majority of people will react that way to you as well.
Okay. Frank, thank you. Obviously, you know, I'm sure this is a difficult subject for certain people to listen to, but obviously very important and something to take note of. So thank you so much for this.
This is a horrible tragedy that happened, and I'm hoping that even in light of this horrible tragedy, it might bring some attention to some people out there who are hurting right now. And these are not the people going out on a killing rampage. These are people that are struggling with personal demons, and if we can at least get them to know that there is a light to the end of this tunnel, and you can start to love yourself, and through that, allow other people to love you too, then we can do something good even through this tragedy.
That's relationship coach Frank Kermit. Learn more about him on his website, franktalks.com.
If you need help with your relationships, my buddy Frank, he's got some tips. Just go to franktalks.com. His advice is better than your mom's. He knows what you're going through. Frank has been there too. So log on to franktalks.com. franktalks.com.
Need help with love, sex, dating and relationships? Visit franktalks.com.
Need help with love, sex, dating, or relationship issues? Help from Frank Kermit, the best-selling author and Canada's most international relationship coach, is only a click away at franktalks.com.
What do you do when you feel like a fool? When your heart has been broken again? Pick up the phone or get onto Skype and talk on a private session. Yeah,
get a little help from Frank Talks.
Whoa, whoa, get to turn things around.
Just sign up at franktalks.com.
Yeah,
get by with help from Frank Talks.
I get
by with little help from Frank Talks. Time to try a little help from Frank Talks.
Best rate going around.
Could it cost a lot of money?
guess we're certain. Just read the reviews.
Five roses up and five summer goods.
Good love can soon come to you.